Hello, mic test, mic test. Hello everyone, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. So if you are interested to know how to extract real-time crypto prices in Python using Binance without making an account in Binance, then you're at the right place. In this video, I'll talk about using WebSocket client Python package to extract crypto pricing data without spending a penny. And you know what guys, I used the same library in my previous video as well, in which I created a Bitcoin day trading bot, and guys, it generated some excess return. So if you are interested to know more, just click on this I button. It has a higher Sharpe ratio than Bitcoin. And before we get into WebSockets, if you are new around here on this channel, I turn you into a successful financial programmer. Here I upload videos on things like trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, some very cool finance APIs, etc, etc. So if this is something you are interested in, then smash on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. Also, I offer an amazing gift to all my lovely subscribers. Just keep watching this video and you'll get to know. Shout out to my new Patreon members, Alex and Sohil. I hope you'll be enjoying the services that I'll be providing on Patreon. So topics that will be covered in this video are: what is WebSocket, installation of WebSocket client Python package, how to extract real-time Bitcoin price in Python using Binance, WebSocket stream without making an account, and it can be any other cryptocurrency as well, as a stored Bitcoin here. How to make real-time candlesticks, it's very important. And in the end, how we can introduce our trading logic through WebSocket in Binance to make a trading bot. So what is WebSocket? WebSocket is basically a two-way communication system where we not only extract information from any particular server, but also can provide some information such that that server takes an action on the basis of that information. So in our case, we'll be using WebSocket client Python package, and it will be used to extract the cryptocurrency pricing data from Binance API. And then we can also send some information to execute some trades on Binance platform. And this is the description of WebSocket client Python package. I have mentioned the link in the description box. And you can see that it provides access to low-level APIs for WebSocket. And we will be using this Python package only to interact with Binance API. And these are the functions that we'll be using in our code. If you want to read more about WebSocket client, here's the WebSocket client documentation. The link is in the description box, but I'll cover almost everything related to this documentation. And in order to interact with Binance, we'll be required to refer this documentation, which is WebSocket streams for Binance. Again, the link is in the description box. And I'll be using all this information like the base endpoint, the streams, and etc. In our Python code. So let's jump to Python and extract some real-time crypto prices. I'm using Google Colab to record this video. You can use any other Python platform like Anaconda, JupyterLab, etc. So yeah, let's first install WebSocket client. Pip install WebSocket client. Perfect, it's installed now. And so let's import WebSocket, and we will also be required to use JSON. Now let's see what is the endpoint that I was referring to. This is the starting for extracting the crypto prices, and let me just provide the name socket here. Socket is equal to, and then this is the WebSocket link that I'll be referring to extract the prices. So if we go here, it's written that we start with the base point, then after that we need to provide WS forward slash WS, and so it will be like this. And then after that, we just need to provide the stream name. So there are different stream names that we can provide. There are different types of data that we can extract using this link. The data can be aggregate trade streams that I'm not interested in, the trade stream again I'm not interested in, candlestick streams, this is the thing that I'm interested. So I'll be using this one. So where is the stream? The stream name for this is @ kline. K represents to candlestick, so @ kline, and then interval. So if we see, there are various intervals that can be used here, from 1 minute to 1 month. So let me just copy and paste this in our code like this, and this in this case, let's just write interval to be 1 minute. Okay, so now let's see where to provide the symbol name. Okay, so before @ we needed to provide the symbol as well. So let me just copy this and paste it here for the symbol name, and in our case, in this case, let's just provide BTC USD. right, let's check it again. So yeah, it's written here that we need to provide BTC USD and then T It represents, I think it represents for trading. So what we'll have to do is BTC USDT here. It's better to make it user friendly. So let me just provide a F string here, and the name of the cryptocurrency is equal to BTC USD. Now actually I'm very much interested to know which currency is your favorite, which cryptocurrency is your favorite cryptocurrency except Bitcoin. Just mention in the comment box, is it Litecoin, Ethereum, etc. I'm very much interested to know, because this is how we get the interest of my target audience, and then future I'll be covering the related topics. So yeah, in this case, I've provided CC is equal to this, and then interval is equal to, let's say in this case, 1 minute. You can provide any other interval if you want. Let me just convert it into this CC and interval. Perfect. Now let's run it. Okay, there's an error. Interval, spelling of interval is wrong. Let's see what is socket now. It's great. Now, in order to use the WebSocket, let's refer to this code. We have generated our WebSocket link, and then we'll be required to use this line here. So let me just provide it like this. And then I don't require open connection. So there's no need of this. And then message is important. Error is not important. So let me just delete this as well. And then in the end, on close. Now what is all these things, I'll tell you in a moment. So basically this is the way we extract information, and the first thing that we need to provide is the socket. So in this case, it should be socket, and then on message is equal to on message, the type of the message that we need to extract, and then on close is equal to close. So what thing should be executed when we close this connection. So for this, I'll have to provide some functions, because I'm writing on message here. So def on message, and then actually I'm like just following these instructions. So let me just copy and paste it like this. I don't require error here. Let me just use on message and on close. So WS represents to this, and then message, and then print message. WS is this. Let me just write it to connection closed, right? So let's run it. Now, if I write ws.runForever, I should be getting all the prices of Bitcoin second by second. So let's see. If I run this like this, yes, you can see that the prices are coming. This is the real-time data actually. So what type of data I'm getting through using the Kline is timestamp, then the interval, open, close, high, low, volume, and then this is very important, X is equal to false. Now what does it mean? If you remember that we provided 1 minute interval here in our code, but the data which is getting extracted is for each and every second. So in order to make a 1 minute interval candlestick, we need this X here. If this X is equal to false, then it means that this 1 minute candle is not closed. If this X is equal to true, then it means that this candle is closed, and then we can take the data of that particular row. So in this case, let's see if we have got any true here. So it's false, and then we have got a true here, and after many falses there will be one more true, yeah, like this one. So these two rows are actually the most important rows for making the candlesticks. When I ran this cell, then it was throwing me all the messages. When I'll close this cell, then I should get a connection closed message in the end. So let's see, have you got it? So the connection is closed, that's it. So this is how we can extract the prices. And so we have covered what is WebSocket installation, and then how to extract real-time Bitcoin price in Python without making an account. Now let's make the candlesticks. And let me tell you one thing, I'll be saving this code in my Google Drive. Actually, this is the gift to all my subscribers. I share my Google Drive with everyone, and my already existing subscribers, they already know this thing. If you are new, just like this video, comment something good, go to my YouTube channel and subscribe, and then click on this access to my Google Drive button. Follow some instructions and just provide that email address, and I'll be using that email address to provide a free access of my Google Drive. Everything is free for use. There are many codes that are saved in that Google Drive, and there are no copyright issues. This code will be saved over there, and not only this one, the code that I'm going to show you very soon, that is my Bitcoin Trading Bot code. Actually, this one, I'll talk about this very soon, is also over there. So you can just copy and paste it for your personal uses. Now, before we see how to make the candlesticks, guys, I have a very small request to you. I got an email from YouTube that most of my viewers are viewing all my videos frequently, but not subscribing to my YouTube channel. Guys, just one click, please. Just subscribe and like this video. It really helps with the algorithm and I want your help to grow as well. Okay, so the things that I'll have to change is, actually, let me just delete this. It's better to convert these dictionaries in the JSON format. So JSON message is equal to JSON.loads and then message. And then inside this message, I'm only interested in this dictionary, which is K. Candle is equal to message. Sorry, candle is equal to JSON message and then K. What else? Now, the next thing that I am interested to know is whether the candle is closed. So for this, I would be required to get what is present in this X. So is candle closed is equal to inside this candle, I will be required to see X. If it's true, then yeah, it's good. If it's false, then it's not closed. What more things I'm interested is close is equal to candle and then C and then high is equal to candle H, low is equal to candle and then low, volume is equal to candle and then V. So let's print everything and let's see if everything is right. So print close, print high, print low, print vol. So from the cell ws dot run forever. So yeah, perfect. So we are printing the low, sorry, the close, high, low and volume for all the seconds. Now we need to make in order to make the candlesticks, we will have to introduce some lists. And then for all the close points, we will be appending values in those lists. So there will be a list called closes, which is an empty list right now, high, highs and lows. And then all these are empty lists. So what I'll be doing is for all the places where is candle closed is true, it will append the value of close in closes. So we'll have all these lists which will be increasing for all the values where the value of X is equal to true. So for this, I'll just have to provide some basic if statement, conditional statement. If is candle closed is true, then this basically closes dot append, and then let's take float of close. Similarly for highs and lows, I'll have to append values. So highs, high, and for lows, yeah, that's low. Now let's print all these candlesticks. So print, print, closes, print, highs, and then print, lows. So let's run this cell. Yeah. So now we'll have to wait for, oh, that's great. So there's the candle just closed here. So you could see that this is the candle. This is the 1 minute interval candle. With time, these lists will get increase in size because all the new values of close, high, low will get appended to all this list. So let's wait for some time and let's see. So after waiting for some time, you can see that our candlesticks are now getting prepared. So you can see then this is the first record, this is the second one, and you can see that all these lists are getting appended, these are getting increased with all the new data. And now you can use all these candlesticks for making a graph, making a screener, or making a web application, or making a trading bot that I actually did. I use these candlesticks to make a Bitcoin trading bot, and this is the code. And I use Arun technical indicator to make the trading logic. And on the basis of this, you can see that this code is exactly the same that we made. And then in the end, I have introduced some other things like Arun and all these things, and using this trading logic here. This code will be saved in my Google Drive as well. You'll also see how I use Talib library and how I made a paper trading simulation. If you're interested to know how to extract the historical pricing data and want to get intervals like 1 minute interval, 15 minutes interval data, then you should check out my videos on Alpha Vantage 12 data and IEX Cloud. If you want to support me and reap some extra benefits, then you can become a Patreon member. And the link is in the description box, and you can see that there are various levels that are in my Patreon page. The services are like Patreon only posts, tip of the day, and then if you click here, there are more levels like Platinum, Legend and God level for different services like WhatsApp group, premium fintech posts, code of the week, etc. And these are the services for this one. It's not very expensive, and this is how you will be supporting me as well. You can also tip me for this video by buying me a coffee. The link is in the description box. You can just select 1, 3 or 5 number of coffees. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and over there you can see that how I used Talib library, which is technical analysis library, and over there you can see how I created a Bitcoin trading bot and incorporated all these libraries over there. Like, share, comment and subscribe. See you in my next video.